It's Reggae Month and the Creative City of Kingston is teeming with all things cultural. But we also have recorded our first case of Zika virus on the island. While you enjoy Reggae Wednesdays at Mandela Park in Halfway Tree, Reggae University at the Edna Manley College, or the JaRIA Honor Awards, protect yourself from mosquito bites. Wear long-sleeved, light-colored clothing, and be sure to use mosquito repellent containing deet. You're tuned in to Jamaica Magazine, your go-to program for all things Jamaican. We have a lot in store for you, so please stay with us.
Hold up your hand. Zik V in the Caribbean territory, but we now want that virus to set pan we. So make sure send no stagnant water inside and mash up all mosquito breed inside. Pour hole in the tin them where you dash by and change the water in your vase every day. No litter, dispose of your garbage proper. You know them the tin them with country and backer. Tour your community and tour your yard for suppress mosquito. We half a go hard. Dash with old tire turnover drum pan for prevention is the greatest weapon. And special shout out to pregnant ladies. Protect yourselves and protect your babies. Draw for your zapper and your mosquito spray. If you do all that we can for keep them away. For we now was in me.
Good day, I'm Tamara McHale, and this is your JIS News for Monday, February 8. Motorists traveling into downtown Kingston along East Avenue and Harbour Street will soon enjoy greater ease and a 30% improvement in travel time. Transport and Works Minister Dr. Omar Davies signed a $20.5 million contract last Friday for the corridor to be upgraded.
Through this contract signing, we'll be achieving the following at the end of 14 months, widening of approximately 2.5 kilometers of the roadway between East Avenue and Harbour Street. This will see the number of lanes moving from 4 to 6.
The realigned corridor will have sidewalks installed on both sides of the road. The work will also include installing pedestrian facilities at 7 traffic signals and a drainage improvement. Dr. Davies says the reduction of traffic and conflict points on the roads will increase safety. 3 new fire trucks have been added to the Jamaica Fire Brigade's fleet. The units, which cost $1.36 million, were officially handed over last week by local government and community development minister Noel R. Scott. They will be deployed to the corporate area, St. James and St. Anne.
These units, ladies and gentlemen, will serve to burnish the already positive reputation that the Jamaica Fire Brigade has for its constancy of purpose and unswerving sense of duty.
Minister R. Scott said a fireboat had also been ordered for the fire brigade. Industry Minister Anthony Hilton is insisting that Jamaica must make greater use of cold chain logistics technology to generate more exports. Cold chain refers to the management of temperature-sensitive products as they move through a particular supply chain. Minister Hilton says cold chain logistics is becoming more important to countries owing to the huge and increasing demand for agricultural products, manufactured foods, chemicals, and medical vaccines.
Cold chain logistics is considered as a huge competitive advantage because it extends product shelf life, thereby giving the suppliers the ability to access overseas markets and also to meet local demand for similar products from overseas.
The minister was addressing a recent forum on cold chain logistics. Research has started on the creative industry's impact on the local economy. The National Cultural and Creative Industries Commission staged a one-day research symposium at the U.S. Mona Visitors Lodge on Friday. Dozens of cultural practitioners participated in the symposium, providing data on the creative economy. Commerce Minister Anthony Hilton, who represented the Prime Minister, said government needed the data to grow a high-value and value-adding creative sector.
Our bilateral and multilateral partners also require more and better data in order to justify their assistance with projects and programs. Our local financial institutions also require economic data to be able to provide financial services for their cultural and creative industry customers.
The one-day symposium was a key move to advance government's policy agenda and strengthen the impact of the cultural and creative industries on national development. And finally, the National Registry of Entertainment Practitioners is expected to be launched early this year. More than 351 individuals and 45 companies have signed up with the registry since the responsible unit was opened in the Ministry of Tourism and Entertainment more than a year ago. The industry ministry through JAMPRO also holds a creative industries unit, and the portfolio minister says that registry will add to the array of offerings in the local creative sector.
2016 is already shaping up to be an exciting year for cultural and creative industries. We are now in the midst of Reggae Month. This will be the first celebration of Reggae Month since Kingston's designation as a creative music city.
The entertainment registry is open to all creative practitioners in various sectors, including dance, film, fashion, music, and the visual and performing arts. And that's it for JIS News today. I'm Tamar McHale. Thanks for watching.
This is the Aedes aegypti mosquito that spreads the Zika, chikungunya, and dengue viruses. Protect yourself from the bite of this mosquito. A message from the Ministry of Health.
We want a productive Jamaica. We are a productive Jamaica. Productivity to move forward on this land. That's the way to go, we should understand. Productivity is the way to go for all us Jamaicans. Small business, big business, old and young, we are tell every woman and man. We want growth and prosperity, free a better nation with a building plan. So we can build our product and sell our product and put more money in our hand. Our economy can rise to a level and build a better nation. Productivity to move forward on this land. Productivity, that's the way to go, we should understand. Productivity to move forward on this land. Productivity, that's the way to go, we should understand. Productivity.
Productivity, pathway to prosperity. A message brought to you by the Jamaica Productivity Center, a department of the Ministry of Labor and Social Security.
Last week, Prime Minister Portia Simpson-Miller unveiled a comprehensive Zika virus containment plan. She also opened another leg of the North-South link of Highway 2000. Catch these and other stories in Jamaica House Weekly next.
In Jamaica House Weekly, Prime Minister updates country on plans to reduce the Zika virus's impact. Angel Celine's did leg of Highway 2000 opened and $182 million farm road program launched.
Everyone must get involved in taking urgent action. Our local authorities, schools, private and public sector, workplaces, churches and individuals in their homes must be vigilant against the spread of this mosquito-borne virus. Everyone must exercise personal responsibility in this regard.
Prime Minister Portia Simpson-Miller's rallying call to Jamaicans as the government implements vector control measures against the Zika virus. In a national broadcast Tuesday, Mrs. Simpson-Miller said there would be increased fogging in high-risk areas. Volunteers would be deployed to identify and destroy mosquito breeding sites, increased capacity to test for the Zika virus, as well as free medication made available to treat symptoms.
The Ministry of Health will spend an additional $200 million to deal with the Zika virus threat. At the same time, a major cleanup campaign will be undertaken by the Ministry of Transport, Works and Housing under the JEEP program with funding from the Tourism Enhancement Fund.
Before the national broadcast, Mrs. Simpson-Miller met with the business community, enlisting their help to control the Zika virus. PSOJ President William Mafood told the Prime Minister that the private sector would be supporting the government's plans by mobilizing staff members to carry out sensitization campaigns at their workplaces and the surrounding communities.
Today, we are taking another important step forward. The attention to farm roads is an important part of my government's commitment to rural development.
On February 2, Mrs. Simpson-Miller launched the second phase of a three-phase national farm road rehabilitation program. The $182 million project forms part of the $1.2 billion national program. This leg, which is expected to be completed by the end of March, will impact over 11,500 farmers in 22 farming communities across 10 parishes.
The program is being implemented as a catalyst for rural development, and it represents a major investment in the farmers of Jamaica.
By Thursday, Mrs. Simpson-Miller was in St. Catherine, opening the Angel Stillinston leg of the North-South link of Highway 2000.
This investment will have multiple impacts, opening up new opportunities for economic growth and job creation for our people. Jamaicans will now have greater choices of where to live, work, do business, and engage in recreation.
As of today, the 16-kilometer stretch of roadway is open to the motoring public. The roadway will be free of toll charges until March, when the Mandela to Angels leg of the highway is opened. On Friday, Mrs. Simpson-Miller sent Minister Anthony Hilton to represent her at the National Cultural and Creative Industries Commission Symposium. Through Minister Hilton, the Prime Minister said extensive work was being done across all ministries to develop the cultural and creative industries. It was pointed out that cultural industries would be the focus of Jamaica Day 2016 in all schools.
These are all elements of creating an enabling environment in which cultural and creative professionals and businesses can thrive.
Last Wednesday, Mrs. Simpson-Miller held talks with the Secretary General of the International Telecommunications Union, ITU. At the meeting, the Prime Minister thanked the ITU for its support for Jamaica's effort to fight cybercrime. She looked forward to further cooperation between Jamaica and the ITU. And the gender affairs portfolio received some attention this past week. On Thursday, the minister responsible for information, Senator Sandra Faulkner, visited the Women's Center Foundation of Jamaica with a delegation from the Cuban embassy. She said government was looking to improve the services of the center.
We're looking at the impact it has had and how we can reach more girls and how we can improve the impact of the program across the island. And although it has been so successful and so many countries across the world, they have patterned it, we are not sitting down and we want to improve on what we have here.
And that's it for Jamaica House Weekly. Join us next time for the latest stories coming out of the office of the Prime Minister.
I say be careful what you teach your little children. Make sure I know something to hurt them. Mind what you say to my sister. She could be the next prime minister.
Children in Jamaica constitute anyone who is under the age of 18 years. And so once you have a child who is under your care and supervision, we encourage you at the Office of the Children's Advocate to always know where your children are. It doesn't mean that you have to be there with them, but you certainly know who they're with, where they're going, and the purpose for being there. This is a key component in helping to establish some rules in terms of some ground rules and helping to guide your children towards responsible and sensible choices, and also assisting you if something were to go wrong to know what is the first point of contact to assist your child. While you're not to look at everybody as a potential suspect, that you need to be very wary of adults, whether they're in positions of authority or not, that seek to want to have a very close relationship with your child. Somebody who wants to invite your child on an outing and it's just that adult and your child alone. Somebody who wants to take your child to a very special event to reward the child, perhaps for some performance that the child would have done in an extracurricular activity or for academic excellence. We encourage you to look at these situations very carefully and to determine whether or not it's an appropriate meeting or outing that this person is propositioning for your child. If you're enrolling your child in a daycare, ensure that you know something about the track record of that daycare. Ensure that the daycare has what we call an open door policy, which allows you to go in, see what's happening, observe how the workers there interact with the children, and know some of the ground rules that guide these interactions. If they're going on outings, whether it be school trips or otherwise, ensure that at some point, even if you can't go to all, you do attend some of them, so you get yourself integrated into the system and the culture of the school. For these tips, and of course any other information that deals with children, that is anyone under 18 years, please feel free to contact the Office of the Children's Advocate. We're at 72 Harbour Street, downtown Kingston, and our numbers are 948-1134, or website www.oca.gov.jm.
Watch what you teach your little children. Make sure I know something to hurt them. Mind what you say to my sister, cause she could be the next prime minister.
On February 25, eligible Jamaicans aged 18 years and older will decide who will make up the next government. We give you an insight into how the business of choosing your political representative goes.
General elections in Jamaica are constitutionally due every 5 years, but the Prime Minister has the right to call an election at any appropriate time. In this case, it's Prime Minister Portia Simpson Miller.
First thing she does is takes her pen and paper and writes to the Governor General and asks him to issue a writ. And he issues a writ which has in it the election date. So strictly speaking, it's the Governor General who carries out her wishes or his wishes for the election date.
Now, once the writ is issued, everything is measured against it. Parliament has to be dissolved, meaning the House of Representatives and the Senate will not meet under normal circumstances.
They can't carry bills to Parliament, they can't get any laws passed or bylaws passed, there can be no debates. But government must continue and they carry out their functions until the swearing-in of the new Prime Minister.
That means until a new Prime Minister is sworn in, the Ministers of Government, for example Security and Finance, should continue to fully execute their duties. Now back to the matter of the election date. After the date is announced, Section 21 of the Representation of the People Act says that nomination day should be at least 5 clear days after the announcement. Section 21A of the Act also states that election day should not be less than 16 days and not more than 23 days after nomination day. Which is why when the Prime Minister announced the election date on Sunday, January 31, she also indicated that Parliament would be dissolved on Friday, February 5. Nomination day is Tuesday, February 9, and the general election will be Thursday, February 25. On nomination day, the process is simple. All candidates contesting the general election have to formally indicate their decision to do so.
There are certain rules relating to the nomination day as to when you can start and when it must end. Those processes are to allow not just the main political parties but independent persons to be able to come forward and make themselves available. And they have rights similar to the main political parties for the nomination of candidates.
Candidates, whether independent or supporters of established political parties, should fill out the nomination form. That form has to be signed by any 10 registered voters in the constituency. It should then be submitted to the returning officer at the nomination center between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. on nomination day. A fee is also required. Then, on election day, winners are identified based on the first-past-the-post system under the Westminster System of Governance. The candidate with the most electoral votes in a particular constituency will be named the Member of Parliament for that area and occupy a seat in the House of Representatives. There are 63 seats, representing 63 constituencies, in the House of Representatives or the lower house. A political party is declared the victor if its candidates secure the most seats. The party or parties with the remaining seats will form the opposition.
The Governor General, in his discretion, and those are the words in the Constitution, determines who commands a majority of the members of the lower house.
That individual would then become the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister is later sworn in, and among the first order of business is to name a cabinet, that is, ministers with different portfolios in government. Some of these ministers will come from the pool of individuals who won their seats on election day, traditionally from the ruling party. Not less than 2 and no more than 4 of the ministers may sit in the Senate, also called the Upper House of Parliament. Unlike the House of Representatives, members of the Senate are not voted in or elected representatives. 13 of the 21 members are appointed by the Governor General on the advice of the Prime Minister, and the remaining 8 by the Leader of the Opposition. That, in essence, is how the electoral process and governance system works in Jamaica. But it doesn't work without your participation. You have the right to vote. And if your name is on the voters list on February 25, go and vote for the candidate of your choice.
Way to vote. Step 1. Find out exactly where you are to vote before election day.
Adrian Atkins.
Step 2.
Thank you very much.
Present your voter's identification card and follow the instructions of the presiding officer. Step 3. Once your identity has been verified and your name is found on the voter's list, you will be issued a ballot paper. Step 4. Go behind the voting booth and mark an X with the pencil provided beside the candidate of your choice. Then, fold your ballot twice, leaving the flap out. Step 5. Give the ballot to the presiding officer. Then, dip your right index finger in the electoral ink and watch while your unopened ballot is put in the box. Step 6. Leave the vicinity in a peaceful manner.
Your vote is your voice. Make it count.
With February being Reggae Month, we give you some insight on the business side of music.
There's a quote from recording artist Erykah Badu who once said, "The music business is motivated by money. Music is motivated by energy and feelings." What say you?
The business of music now is to take all of that and turn it into making money, you know, as blatant as that.
This is Career Talk. I'm Kerry. Today we're discussing music management and more. Welcome.
They get the fame, top the charts, collect the awards, are recorded in the annals of history for speaking to the multidimensional spectrum of human emotions and experiences through the power of music. But the difference between them and the far greater number of musical unknowns is very often in the management.
The Eptones, Ken Booth, Delroy Wilson, Alton Ellis, I mean, you name them, they came through my hands at some stage or another. I took Dennis to England in 74, the first time he toured. He was just about 17.
Junior Lincoln is one of a large and growing group of people who have merged a love for the melodic creation called music with a keen understanding of human behavior and a sharp business mind to make a living.
Some of the best artists in the world, we don't know anything about. You can be the greatest artist in the world and if people don't hear you, how are they going to know? And how are you going to be heard? It takes management. Music management is kind of complex.
But it comes down to one thing, overseeing the business affairs of musicians.
There's two sorts of management of an artist. I mean, the personal manager will look at how they invest their money, how they do all of that sort of thing. The other side now, which is the professional manager of the artist's career.
If you are looking to join this career field, be prepared to handle just about every aspect of an artist's career.
It is not something that you can go to school and learn. You know, it's something you learn over a period of time with experience.
But school can't hurt. In fact, there are schools here in Jamaica and abroad offering degree programs in music business or a straightforward business field that you can merge with your knowledge of the industry. Whether you begin with formal training or not, getting started in this career is tough. One route is to cultivate a relationship with an up-and-coming artist you admire and begin to manage that person, create an effective street team, and help the artist grow. Then there's another option.
You find a lot of big managers today, especially overseas, started with a company. and they would have maybe two or three artists and under their portfolio. So you learn your craft there, but you have this big company behind you to that you can rock back at.
Whatever in you use, remember this is not a job that will keep you confined to a desk or any other static location. You go where the business or the artist goes. And this is not a 9-to-5 gig.
No, it's the opposite of a 9-to-5 job because you're on the job all the time.
And it's a job that is in demand, a growth field as some would call it.
What you have to keep in touch with is the change. The changes that has come about in the business, and continually doing so.
There are some other intangibles to consider.
Temperament is important. It's cool when you have to be cool, and most of the time you have to be cool, but you have to be firm when you have to be firm. It takes man management.
It means navigating the many moods of artists, plus all the people around them.
I think we all know that people within the arts are a bit sometimes not so easy to deal with, for obvious reasons, you know. Very moody, you know, can be very strong in their thoughts and vision and whatever else. You know, there's got to be trust. There's got to be confidence, a whole lot of confidence in the management opinion and direction of that artist.
The music manager must also understand how to navigate the transition from an unknown artist to someone with a following and further a national or international career.
Once you get there, a very important part is to stay there. And management is very crucial to that, because it's not just music anymore, you know, it's music plus.
When will I see you again?
It keeps our bodies working, our food nutritious, our living and working spaces clean, and our lives comfortable. Water, the most precious resource necessary for the sustenance of life on our planet. Don't waste it. Let's conserve on this critical commodity. In the house, invest in storage containers and buckets. Take quick showers instead of long baths, and invest in water-efficient showerheads, toilets, and faucets. You may also want to consider one-pot meals and cooking methods that don't require much water. You could also wash fruits and vegetables in a bowl and reuse the water on your plants or grass. When cleaning dishes, fill both sinks and use one for washing and the other for rinsing. The leftover water can be used to wash off the concrete or asphalt in your yard. If you must wash your car at home, aim for once a fortnight and use a bucket to do the washing instead of running the hose. Don't delay. Start your water conservation practices today.
As we close our show, we want to remind you of your duty to protect yourself and your family. Detect and destroy mosquito breeding sites. The power is in your hands. For more information, visit jis.gov.jm. Check us out on Facebook and Twitter. Keep connected while you're on the go by downloading our mobile app from the Google Play Store. On behalf of the entire team here at the JIS, I'm Adrian Atkinson, thanking you for watching.
This has been a production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.